إن الحمد لله تبارك وتعالى نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله عز وجل، وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وما قل ودل خير مما كثر وألهى، وقليل يغنيك خير من كثير يطغيك، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. وبعد، dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, today inshallah we have hadith number 11 in the 40 Nawawi ahadith, في الأربعين النووية الحديث الحادي عشر إن شاء الله تعالى. And this hadith is reported by Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah, and it's an authentic hadith from Al-Hasan ibn Ali, the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah used to say about Al-Hasan ibn Ali and his brother, Huma rayhanatay fi hadhihi dunya. Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn are the two flowers that give my life a good smell in this world, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to love Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn so much. And the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has taught Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn a lot. And one of the qawa'id, or one of the basis that he used to repeat in his household, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a lot, is what Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu is telling us in here. He says, حَفِظْتُ مِنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ I have memorized from the mouth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He didn't say I've heard once or twice or three times or even 10 times. He said I have memorized it. I have memorized it. What's that hadith? قَالَ دَعْ مَا يَرِيبُكَ إِلَى مَا لَا يَرِيبُكَ فَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ طُمَأْنِينَ وَإِنَّ الْكَذِبَ رِيبَةٌ. The base, or the rule, or the principle that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his family frequently is, leave that which causes you doubt for that which causes you no doubt, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's our hadith today. It's a very important principle in our religion. Leave that which causes you doubt to that which causes you no doubt. فَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ وَفِي رِوَايَةَ الْخَيْرِ طُمَأْنِينَةَ Indeed truthful, truthfulness, indeed good stuff is tranquility, it brings tranquility to your life, to your heart. وَإِنَّ الْكَذِبَ وَفِي رِوَايَةَ وَإِنَّ الشَّرَّ رِيبَةَ And lying and evil is riba, is doubt in your heart, doubt in your life. This is the principle that we have from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam today. It's a very important qa'idah. At the beginning, I want to tell you and also to learn with you from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how can I identify if something is bad or not? If I don't have enough knowledge in Sharia, how would I know that that thing is haram or halal? Or even if it's a doubtful matter and I have no idea. And if you just pay a little bit of intention, inshallah, which you do, you will see this hadith is somehow connected to the hadith that we discussed last Friday. And that's actually from the fiqh and the understanding of Al-Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah min fahmihi al-amiq annahu ja'a bihadha al-hadith ba'da hadith al-mutashabihati fi al-deen. It's from his fiqh radiallahu anhu that he narrated this hadith after the hadith that we discussed last Friday that it speaks about the doubtful matters in Islam. So how would I identify? How can I know? كيف أعرف إذا كان هذا الأمر هو فيه شك أو ليس فيه شك؟ والإجابة على ذلك في الحديث الذي روي عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن سيدنا أبي هريرة أن رسول الله قال لأحد من الصحابة: دع ما يريبك إلى ما لا يريبك. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said to one of his companions the same قاعدة, the same principle: leave that which causes you doubt to that which causes you no doubt. Then the Sahabi asked a direct question to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم: وكيف أعرف يا رسول الله, how would I know if it's actually doubtful matter or not doubtful matter? فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: ضع يدك على قلبك. Look at this. That's the strategy. That's the way to know if you're doing something right or wrong. Please concentrate with this tawjih from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with this instruction from him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ضع يدك على صدرك. Put your hand in your chest. Put your hand in your chest. When you're going to do something and you're not sure if it's doubtful or not, put your hand in your chest. قال sallallahu alayhi wa sallam: فإن القلب يضطرب للحرام. Your heart will never feel calm. You will never have any tranquility in your heart while you're doing something. You will try to hide it from every person. You don't want anybody to see you doing that. يعني تبذل ما في وسعك حتى تخفي هذا الأمر لأنك تعلم أنك على خطأ. وهذه هي العلامة. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: ويسكن يعني القلب للحلال. And القلب feels calm when it's something halal. صلى الله عليه وسلم. You know when somebody is doing something evil or something wrong, or he knows from himself that he's wrong. He tries his best to hide it, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exposes it somehow subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني يفعل ما بوسعه حتى يخفي هذا الخطأ الذي يفعله, لكن الله عز وجل يصر على أن يظهر للناس ما فعله. صلى الله على النبي وآله وصحبه, اللهم آمين. Today I just want to tell you the next point. We're not talking about haram and halal. We're talking about ورع. ورع means it's the highest level of this Islam. When you leave something that is not actually haram because you're scared to do the haram stuff, the actual haram stuff, that's called wara in our religion, to keep a distance between you and the doubtful matters. I will give an example from the life of the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu wa arda, كان له غلام يخرج له الخراج. Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Anhu had a slave. And you know, back in the day, if you have a slave, he goes to work, and whatever he earns, he has to give you as a master a percentage from his income. Like Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Anhu used to take from him, for example, 10%, more or less, from his slave. That was back in the day. لو كان عندك عبد هو يعمل ويعطيك نسبة من كسبه. وهذا كان عادة الناس قبل أن يأتي الإسلام ويقضي على العبودية. And then that slave one time, he brought his kharaj to Sayyidina Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه. Sayyidina Abu Bakr used to put this to his money and just eat for, and use the whole thing for his household رضي الله عنه. فجاءه هذا الغلام وقال: يا أبا بكر, يا خليفة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, هل تعلم من أين هذا الخراج؟ That slave came to his master Abu Bakr and he said, do you know where I earned this money from? Abu Bakr said, where did you earn this from? He said, كنت قد تكهنت كهانة في الجاهلية. يعني هذا من كسب الحرام. يعني هذا الرجل كان يعمل دجالا, والناس كانوا يسألونه عن الغيب ويعطونه أموال قبل أن يسلم, ثم تاب بعد الإسلام. فما كان من سيدنا أبي بكر لما علم ذلك, مع أنه ليس حرام لأبي بكر, هو حرام للعبد لأنه هو الكاهن, لكن أبو بكر أخذ خراجا, هو لم يأخذ حراما رضي الله عنه. ما كان منه إلا أن وضع يده في فيه وقاء كل ما أكله رضي الله عنه. هكذا رباهم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then that slave said to his master Abu Bakr, before I reverted to Islam, I used to be a fortune teller. People used to come and ask me questions about the unseen and then give me money when I give them the answer. And that's actually haram. But that money for Abu Bakr is halal, because he earned this money from a halal process. the income of his slave. But it's only haram for the slave, because he earned this money from fortune telling. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu's reaction, because he wanted to put the distance between him and the doubtful matters, he put his hand in his throat and he tried to throw up everything that he ate. Radiallahu anhu. That's how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to teach his close companions. And the first is Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu arda. Another doubtful matters, the daughter of Abu Bakr. Bint هذا الرجل العظيم Sayyidina Abu Bakr, أمنا عائشة radiallahu anha wa ardaha. سألها بعض الناس عن أكل الصيد للمحرم إذا لم يصده، يعني إنسان آخر صاده له ينفع أكله ولا لا؟ هذا خلاف فقه، لكن هو لا يجوز له أن يصيد بنفسه، إنسان آخر صاد له يأكل ولا لا يأكل فيها خلاف. فقالت رضي الله عنها إنما هي أيام قلائل، فما رابك فدعه، انتظر يا أخي، إذا كان في هناك شك يعني عندك وفي خلاف بين الصحابة في هذه المسألة، خلاص انتظر أيام قلائل. A man came to Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha. You know the muhrim, someone in a state of ihram, he's not allowed to hunt an animal. And he's not allowed to eat from the animal that he hunted. But if somebody hunted an animal for him, is he allowed to eat from that animal or not? As Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha was asked this question. It's now a doubtful matter. The Sahaba have two different opinions in this regard. As Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha said to him, you can wait for a little bit, few days until you finish your hajj, and then when you go back to your family, eat whatever you want. That's how they used to avoid the doubtful matters. Radiallahu anhum wa ardahum. The next point that I would like to talk about today is al-wara'ul kadhib. Please concentrate on this one as well. Al-wara'ul kadhib, the false wara'. I just said wara' is to keep a distance between you and doubtful matters. Wara' kadhib is that some people, they focus so much on the minor issues and they keep a long distance between them and the doubtful matters, but they commit the major sins and do kabair. بعض الناس يتجنب الصغائر ويبتعد عن كل الشبهات لكنه يغتاب الناس وهذه كبيرة لكنه يؤذي المسلمين وهذا حرام وهذا حدث على عهد صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. لما جاء واحد من الخوارج يسأل سيدنا عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص عن دم البعوضة. One of the خوارج came to سيدنا عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص and he asked him, you know, I was walking with my friends and then a fly, a mosquito came on my shoulder and I killed it. He hit the fly and he killed it and there was some blood on his clothes. Then he came to Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As and asked him, can I pray in this cloth? Now it has some blood from the fly. Can I pray with this blood on my cloth? Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Amr al-As was wondering, you just killed al-Husayn. You just killed the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You just killed the brother actually of the narrator of our hadith today. And you're asking about the blood of a mosquito? That's what some people do nowadays. So Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, you're asking about dam al-ba'uda? Sa'alahu, ya'ani fi dam min al-ba'uda ala thiyabi. Yinfa'a salli wa la'u salli. Faqallahu Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Amr, ya'ani anta qatalta al-Husayn. Wa tas'aluni an dam al-ba'uda? Hatha ismuhu wara'un kadhib. That's called false wara' in our religion. Allah does not accept this. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is our religion. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه من كل ذنب إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الله أكبر. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا مولانا رسول الله وآله وصحبه ومن والاه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said in this hadith, فإن الصدق طمأنينة. Indeed, truthfulness is tranquility. وإن الكذب ريبة. And indeed, lying is doubt. Lying is doubt. When somebody lies, you can identify it sometimes. If he's not very good at hiding things. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يطبع المؤمن على الخلال كلها. A believer can have any quality, good or bad, and then he can repent. الخلال كلها, any quality that you can think of, a believer can do it one day and then repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's okay. Allah accepts repentance. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, look, listen, إلا الخيانة والكذب, except lying and betray. A believer does not betray. المؤمن لا يخون. A believer does not lie. المؤمن لا يعرف الكذب. لذلك قال الله في القرآن, look, انظر للآية, يعني كيف تؤكد على معنى الحديث. قال الله تعالى في سورة النحل, إنما يفتري الكذب, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, إنما يفتري الكذب الذين لا يؤمنون بآيات الله وأولئك هم الكاذبون. The same meaning, a believer can't be a liar. Only those who don't believe in the ayat of Allah lie. I don't want to explain more in this hadith because actually it's very hurtful to talk about this hadith. It's not easy. To talk about the false wara', it's difficult. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وإني داع فأمنوا. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين, صل عليه في الآخرين, وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. اللهم علمنا من ديننا ما جهلنا, وانفعنا بما علمتنا, وزدنا يا ربنا علما, وزدنا يا ربنا علما. اللهم ألف بين قلوب المسلمين, وأصلح ذات بيننا يا رب العالمين, وانزع الغل والحقد من صدورنا. اللهم طهر صدورنا وصف نفوسنا, واجعلنا سلما لإخواننا هداة لغيرنا. آمين آمين آمين. وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين, وأقم الصلاة.